In the quiet town of Dallas, Oregon, there's barely a hint of the political drama that's unfolded over the past week after State Representative Mike Nierman, who represents this district, became the first person ever expelled from the Oregon State Legislature.
I believe the right thing was done, and I applaud the legislature for doing so.
Residents in this town west of Salem are somewhat split over Nierman's dismissal.
It's a good idea. That's maybe a little late. It's a good idea.
I think that the liberals got a little carried away and they just wanted to get rid of another Republican. Although all the Republicans also voted to get him out. So I don't know.
I did vote for him. So far, I like him. I think he's good.
Nierman, a Republican who served in the House since 2015, faced calls to resign after allowing far-right demonstrators, some of them armed, into the locked state capitol building as lawmakers met in a special session last December. Efforts to remove Nierman ramped up again last week when video emerged of Nierman plotting the breach with supporters days beforehand.
And if you say, I'm at the west entrance during the session and text to that number there, that somebody might exit that door while you're standing there.
It's egregious to let armed rioters into the capitol, state capitol or the nation's capitol. And, you know, he shouldn't have done it. It was stupid.
In the end, the Oregon House voted 59-1 on Thursday to expel Nierman, who is still facing two criminal charges stemming from his decision to help demonstrators into the Capitol.
And so, seems like they had a majority that wanted him gone, so we'll see what they do with his replacement.
Nierman's seat is now considered vacant, so county commissioners in Benton, Marion, Yamhill, and Polk counties will be responsible for selecting a Republican to fill his spot and serve the remainder of Nierman's term, which runs through next year. Kyle Laboshi, KGW News.